today. Good afternoon to all.
Good afternoon, ma'am.
Okay, today we are starting a new lesson, and it is ratio and proportion. The new lesson's name is ratio and proportion. Okay.
Okay.
Right now, 1 minute. Okay, the chapter's name is
ratio.
R-A-T-I-O. Ratio and proportion. Proportion. Ratio and proportion. Chapter name, chapter number, you know, children? Chapter number?
12.
Chapter 12, ratio and proportion. Okay. So it is a new thing for you, but we are using it unknowingly in our daily life. Okay, ratio we are using. Ratio. Okay, ratio is always used for comparing, comparison, comparing two quantities. Okay, ratio is always used for comparing two quantities. Okay, children?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, ma'am.
So, I'll give you an example. See, suppose your mother is making tea for you and your brother.
Okay.
Okay. So, for two persons, 2 glasses of water, suppose, 2 glasses of water, then what all things needed for tea?
Milk. 2 glasses of milk.
Okay. 2 glasses of milk. My God.
No, 1 glass.
1 glass,
ma'am.
Okay. 2 glasses of water. Okay. 2 glasses of water.
1 glass of milk.
1 glass of milk.
Sugar.
Ah, then tea powder. One spoon enough. One spoon enough.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, 1 spoon tea powder.
Ma'am, sugar.
Sugar.
Ma'am, sugar.
Sugar, we need 3 spoons, suppose.
How much according to taste?
This much. 3 spoons of sugar. Okay, this for 2 persons. Okay, children, this is for 2 persons. Then what happened is, one of your friend has also reached. Two friends visited your home. So is this enough for them?
No,
this is not enough. So if the visitors are there, more visitors are there, or guests are came, so what happens is, this tea is not enough for them. So your mother has to make some, means the measurement or the amount, the quantity of the things used for making tea, she has to make double of it, isn't it? So yes, 4 persons, how she will do?
Ma'am, 4 glasses of water.
4 glasses of water.
2 glasses
of water.
You understood something, no? You are doing here something that unknowingly you are doing some calculations here.
Yes, ma'am.
It?
Yes, ma'am. Multiplication.
Two persons became 4 persons. So you made 2 glasses of water as 4 glasses of water. And 1 glass of milk, how will you make?
Two cups
of milk. Then?
2 spoons.
1 spoon of tea powder.
Two spoons of tea powder.
Then? Again, 3 spoons of sugar you will make us. 6 spoons of sugar. You did something.
We added.
Multiplied
with what? According to this number, Okay, according to this number, see children, according to this number of persons, how that number of persons increased?
Ma'am, number of persons is a variable.
Doubled. Number of persons doubled. So according to that, you made the ingredients or the tea also doubled. Isn't it?
Yes,
so there is, you are doing the calculation unknowingly. That means the number of persons increased, doubled into two. You made the same thing there in the ingredients.
Yes, ma'am.
Clear, children?
Yes, ma'am.
So into two, you did everything into two. Okay, children. See. So this is known as ratio. That means you compared it. You compared the quantities. Now you know how to make idli. Your mother is making idli, right?
Yes, ma'am.
So, rice, then udadila dal, then salt, water. So that mixing is when the persons increases, the mixing of the ingredients or the recipe, the things, the quantity of the things taken for making idli should also be doubled.
Yes,
clear? Okay, clear. Did you understand? So
yes,
this,
ma'am.
This
yes,
comparison,
ma'am.
This we are comparing it in an order. We are comparing it in an order. That comparison is known as order. When we compare one things in order, it is known as ratio. Okay, one more example I'll give you. Okay, have you seen spiders?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
How many legs are there for a spider?
Eight legs.
So I'm drawing one spider. 1, 2, 3, 4. How many legs?
Eight legs.
One spider. How many legs?
Eight legs.
Okay. Another spider. Okay. Like this, you are drawing spiders.
Huh? No, ma'am.
Okay. So anyway, please excuse me. I can draw only this, like this. Okay. Two spiders. How many legs?
16 legs.
How did you understand?
Multiplied by two.
Now I'm drawing three spiders. Like this, we have done the same thing when we did our algebra variables.
Yes.
Isn't it?
Yes, ma'am.
We did the same, like, one calculation there. How many legs will be there, children?
24.
Is there any connection between this?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. One spider, eight legs.
Eight legs.
Two spiders.
16 legs.
Three spiders.
24 legs.
Okay, I'll show you. This is one spider, and ratio we always write in a fraction. Okay, so one spider, and out of how many legs are there for one spider?
Eight legs.
Can you write the fraction of the second one? Two spiders by how many legs? 16 legs. Okay. So will you simplify it?
1/2.
1/2.
1/2.
2.
1/8.
1/8. Okay, again. Third spider. 3/24.
Ma'am, should be
right. Divide by
3.
Answer
1/8.
What did you observe from this? This is known as a perfect ratio, which is a ratio itself is an example of ratio, because when we compared the spider with its legs, we'll get the same ratio. Ratio is a fraction. Clear, children? Ratio is a fraction, and when we compared one spider with its legs, we got 1/8. Two spiders, same 1/8. Three spiders will get the same 1/8 itself. Okay, so this is the comparison. This comparison is known as ratio. Clear, children?
Yes, ma'am.
You got some idea about ratio?
Yes, ma'am.
So ratio and proportion, it is going in a proportion, means it will not change. One, three spiders, 24 legs. Now, what about four spiders? 32 legs. So when you divide 4 by 32, we will get 1/8 itself.
1/8.
Okay. So if one quantity increases, the other quantity also increases. Clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, children. Now, we will write the notes. One second. Let me show the textbook, our chapter to you. One second, children. Why it is not loading? Okay. This is our chapter 12, ratio and proportion. I'll read it. Can you read, children? I'll read it if
yes,
you want.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes.
In our daily life, listen to my reading. You can read also. In our daily life, many a times we compare two quantities of the same type. Okay. Listen to me. No need of writing anything. Listen to me. Avani and Shari collected flowers for scrap notebook. Avani collected 30 flowers and Shari collected 45 flowers. Okay. So we may say that Shari collected 45 minus 30 equal to 15 flowers more than Avani. We used to tell like that, no? So we compared it. Who got more? That is a comparison. When you are getting marks in the test, one student got full mark, other student got less mark. So you used to compare. Who got more? Who got less? Isn't it? That is a type of comparison. Also, if height of Rahim is 150 centimeter and that of Avani is 140 centimeter, then we may say that the height of Rahim is 10 centimeter more than Avani. So that is also one type of comparison. Clear? If we wish to compare the length of an ant and a grasshopper, taking the difference does not express the comparison. The grasshopper's length, typically 4 cm to 5 cm, is too long as compared to ant's length. Because grasshopper's length, elephant's length and ant's length, can we compare together?
No.
So it is too much for comparison. The difference is too long as we compared to ant's length, and it is a few millimeter only. Okay, comparison will be better if we try to find that how many ants can be placed one behind the other to match the length of the grasshopper. Okay, so 20 to 30 ants have the same length as grasshopper. Clear, children?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Clear?
Okay. Yes, ma'am.
So we'll take 20 to 30 ants like this, one by one in a line. So we can compare that length with the ant's grasshopper's length. Clear, children?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Now, consider another example. Cost of a car is ₹2,50,000. And that of a motorbike is ₹50,000. Okay, how can we calculate the difference between the cost? So we compare it by division. Okay. So the cost of the car is 2,50,000 and a motorbike is 50,000. So when you divide it, That comparison will be, that ratio will be 5 by 1. When we divide it, it becomes a ratio. Lot of other comparison you have seen. We subtracted, we added, who got more, who got less. But this comparison, when we divide and find out, that is known as ratio. Clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Clear, children?
Yes, ma'am.
So, we can say that the cost of the car is 5 times the cost of the motorbike. Clear? 50,000, yes. 5 into 5 is 25. So, 50,000 into 5 is 2,50,000. So, thus, in certain situations, comparison by division makes better sense than comparison in taking the difference. So, most of the situations, comparison by division will give us a sense of doing. To understand, that is better. Comparison by division is better, right? So that comparison by division is the ratio. Clear, children? There is a lot of comparison. What is the difference? How much added? How much is more? How much is less? Find the difference. Find the sum. All those comparisons are there. But ratio means the comparison by division. Clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Clear. So we divided spider and by its legs. You understood it better. 1 by 8. Isn't it? So that comparison by division is known as?
Ratio.
Ratio. Okay, children?
Yes, ma'am. Okay, ma'am. Okay.
So will you write the heading?
Yes, ma'am.
Ratio. Write the heading ratio. And? Okay, you write this in certain situations. This is a note. In certain situations, comparison by division, comparison by division is better than comparison by taking the difference. Comparison by taking the difference. Taking the difference.
Ma'am, we have to write.
Yes, yes. The comparison by division is known as comparison by division is known as ratio. This is the note.
Yes, ma'am.
After writing, I'll explain.
Finish, ma'am.
Ma'am, I finished writing.
Okay.
Ma'am, can you show, please?
1 minute.
Ma'am, can you show?
This one. Clear, children? Hmm? Shall I raise now?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. One second. Yes, children, can you see the board now?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, children, will you write this? This one?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
Ma'am, we have to draw the box.
One minute. Okay. No need of writing this. Okay. I'll give the example. No need of writing this. I'll give another note for you. Okay. Start writing. Let me change the color. 1 second, children. Wait. Okay. When we compare two quantities.
Ma'am, continuation.
Continuation. When we compare two quantities in terms of how many times bigger, how many times smaller, like that. How many times? It is called ratio. Okay, after that, next paragraph. You have to write this in a box. Okay. We denote ratio using the symbol this two dots like this up and down and is read as is to. How will you read this?
Is to.
Mm-hmm. Is to. So 6:5. How will you read? 6:5. Example. 1:3 is red. As 1:3.
Mom, can you show that notes because my board was just loading. Now all I got it.
Okay, after writing this, I'll show.
Okay, ma'am. Thank you, ma'am.
Ma'am, only this much. So can we draw a box?
Yeah. Everything together you draw like this. Oh my God. One second.
Finish, ma'am.
Okay, Sri Rudra, I'll show the top writings. Okay. Okay. This one.
Yeah, yeah.
No, also it's just loading. I can't see.
Eh? You cannot see anything? Okay, Sri Rudra.
Ma'am, now I can see, ma'am.
1 second, you write fast.
Okay, ma'am.
Will you take a screenshot?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. So, children, there are some rules for writing. Some rules for writing this ratio. Okay, wait. Okay, so we'll write that. It's very important. Rules for ratio. It's very important. First one, when we write, right, when we write ratio, the order of the quantities, the order of the quantities which, a second, we should keep the
when
order of the
number
quantities
in the order in which the problem
which we
asks for them.
For comparison. Okay. So the first rule, I'll explain all these rules to you. Okay, second one.
Mama.
Okay, okay, no problem. The ratio should be written
lowest
in the
terms.
Yes, yes, yes. In the
lowest
terms. And third one. The ratio should be in the simplest form. Sorry, ratio should be in the same unit. Sorry. Should be in the same units.
Joyle.
Did you write, children?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. No, ma'am.
Wait.
Ma'am, finish.
Okay. All of you finish?
No, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
No, ma'am.
So I will explain the next period. This about these rules. Okay, children.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay, children, shall we end up now? It is time 1:40 now.
Ma'am, can you show?
I forgot the timing.
Ma'am, can you show the line? Maybe not really sure that
one. Yes. It is time, children. It is 1:40 now. Students are in the waiting room. Teacher is also there waiting.
Ma'am, will we be studying types of ratios and proportion?
Types of? No, no. No, no, only some very less. Okay?
Okay, ma'am.
Okay, so... Okay, children, bye. And what time our next class?
Bye, ma'am.
Ma'am,
4:30. Okay, okay. Bye, children.
Bye. Thank you.